Yeah. That's gummy.
Yeah, your tires are caked up. You may have to restart back at the bottom.
It's really just like one bump right there.
Maybe if he tries more driver side.
Yeah, try
hugging the driver. That's so cool. Look at all the mud caked on this tree. Do you think if he started further back, he could clear out the tires? Oof, don't do that. Winch on old Blue wasn't working. It would pull in, but it wouldn't let out. So we've got Jacob at the top of the hill winching in. And before anybody gets mad at me, it is synthetic rope. It is not wire. And there's trees and stuff between us.
You're gonna have to bump it, I think.
You made it further than he did.
Pedal.
trying the other side of this hill. Let's see if we can get up this way. He's also got this huge undercut part right there. That is impressive. All right, stop there, stop there. All right. He's aired down a lot because of how much that rim is, that wheel is, that tire is flexing right there. He's grabbing the ground. Flexing. He's hung up on tree. All right, so he's pulling cable here. Run back over to the other side. We're gonna just try to hit back and forth so we can just keep winches on both sides going. All right, here comes Dusty. You'll have to bump it over that rock. Back it up a little bit and try to bump it. Jake. All right, now he's gonna have the best chance of anybody else that's gone up. He's got 33-inch boggers. Look how high he's staying. Golly. Front diff is catching that rock right there, and it's pulling Jake forward.
Yeah, last time I took my bass down with his four-wheeling, I bounced his head off the seat. He hit the ceiling and hit the windshield, hit the floor. He looked at me like, what the hell, dude? And he's like, what did I do to you?
Oh, come on, stick it.
Golly.
There we go. I was breaking him. Look at that tire flex. I was just saying the same thing.
Is it like rim on the ground?
Oh, no, it's not rim on the ground. I'll show you.
Look at that. It is touching the ground on both sides of the limb.
Really?
Just about.
Oh, here we go.
There we go.
Look at the mud on that front diff, where it's been just dragging that entire way up the mountain. I'm gonna be honest, I'm not bothering to go down there and videoing this. He ain't gonna make it. We're getting him the rest
of the way out, and all I hear is Rev Limiter down the hill.
There we go. There we go. Right when I say that, he snapped an axle. Yeah, I heard rev limiter and went.
And then we look down there and hear that he has a broke axle.
There's zero pressure. Zero.
Nothing.
You just gotta have IROX. Dude, even the hill this thing's on is nuts.
I think he said U joint.
So I'm a liar. He blew the entire rear drive shaft out of that thing, and I'm gonna take it home and rebuild it.
Oh yeah, it's broke.
Look right there. That's the ear off of that rear drive shaft. If nothing else, today has convinced me that I'll be buying a worn Xeon winch. Golly. Jake's Jeep is still putting in that work. All right, here comes the first JK of the group. Let's see what he's got. I don't know the specs on it, but I'm guess it's the 3.6 instead of that 4.0 that everybody else is running. So.
Ah ha ha. Oh, got open discs. Locker. I don't know. Maybe it's in the front. Both the fronts are spinning really well together. Oh, he's got a light whip. That's funny. I'm not thinking that he has a torque locker in the back. It's not grabbing at all. In the front, they're both spinning really well, but I really think that's just an open, probably down at 35, and looks big enough to be a 44. Yeah, we're still doing this. It's been 2 hours. Golly.
We have winched every one of these up, and there's more up the hill.
Except this one.
Except this boy. This boy right here.